طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، أما بعد. إتحاف القاصد بنظم أحكام وقواعد المقاصد. I think we'll be starting from page 10, right? Or no? We already did the مقدمة and then we did شمول الشريعة لجميع المصالح ودرئها لجميع المفاسد. Did we do that, right? So it's in which page you think we start? 10. So we'll be starting from 10, right? Now. Yeah, they distributed last week. We had extra. If I ask Brother Ibrahim, I'm sure he had some left. Yeah. Yeah. Last week we have enough copies, so he might have the remaining in his office. طيب. This fossil is أقسام المقاصد باعتبار المصالح التي جاءت بحفظها. So the intent of the Sharia, the category of the intent of the Sharia based on the maslaha that the Sharia was revealed and in the Sharia, the command to preserve it, to safeguard it, inshallah. We'll wait for the brother. قال مصالح الناس بالاستقراء ثلاثة اعلمها بلا امتراء. مصالح الناس بالاستقراء. مصالح the benefit, what benefit people and lead them, you know, in their the مصلحة. I mean in its wide term, an extensive term, the maslaha. And all of you by now, you know the maslaha, right? So I don't need to, when I say maslaha is enough. And maslaha and mafsada, okay? طيب. The masalah of people, bil istiqra, what is the istiqra? You remember what is the istiqra, right? The istiqra is a way of analysis to get to conclusion. Al istiqra. You know, there's experiment, there's, you know, things like nadariya, and the nadari is what like the theoretical way of analysis, of deduction to lead to conclusion. Al-istiqra'u is the study of the text of the sharia to see the common pattern, you know, that all comes all together. Help us, the scholar, to deduct, you know, what between the lines, what it be said in an explicit way, and all the texts of the Sharia, you know, all of them, they agree about this aspect, this element. Okay. So, مصالح الناس بالاستقراء. So, with the way of the استقراء, we get to the conclusion that three category of مصالح. ثلاث ثلاثة اعلمها بلا امتراء. Know it without any doubt. ضرورة وحاجة تحسين. So we have, you remember we already studied. So the three categories are ضرورة, necessity, حاجة, needed, وتحسين, كماليات. You know, that's the accessories, things of beautification. So وكلها قد ضم هذا الدين وألحقت به مكملات توابع لها متممات. All of it, the Sharia, our deen, has encompassed all these categories. And add to it some of the branches, some of the things that related to them. توابع لها متممات. So توابع, those are branches that we add to these main categories to complete, you know, the whole masalah known, or the whole masalah that the humankind are in need for to live and build life in this on this earth. تفصيلها يتلى عليك فاسمعي من غير إشكال ولا تنطعي. The details of it is going to be related to you, is going to be recited, presented to you, then listen to it. And it's not gonna have any issues or problem in understanding it. And no tanatta. Tanatta is like to go out of the subject and being, you know, talking about things that off the topic. So the first category, قُلْنَا قَالَ ضَرُورَةٌ وَحَاجَةٌ تَحْسِينٌ. The first category is الضروريات. ضرورةٌ, necessity. The title of the category then is الضروريات. الضروريات, the plural of ضرورة. الضرورة are the necessities. So what is the necessity? What is the ضرورة? ضرورة ينمى لها الضروري فهاك معناها بلا قصور. ضرورة, something is a necessity. It is in fact when you have something in necessity, so there's a need for it, right? We're talking about food. So that's from the structure of the human being. They cannot, be independent or no need or live without food. So the food is a ضروري necessity. فهاك معناها بلا قصور. This is the meaning of it, the definition, without shortcoming. ما فقده يؤذن بالهلاك. ما فقده يؤذن بالهلاك. So how can we define الضروريات? Something that is a necessity. When we don't have it, it leads to ruin. It lead to devastation. It lead to chaos. That's how we know, define the ضروري. There's drought, there is no food. What is going to lead to? Famine, starving, death, chaos, all of that. So the absence of food in a society is going to turn to the society all into chaos. This is how we define the ضروري. So what is the ضروري? Is when it disappears from the society, when it lacks in a society, it's going to cause a very deep harm to the society, devastation. That's the ضروري. This is at the level of the society. At the level of the individual, you know, when someone does not have food, and about, you know, to die. Whatever thing he'll find is halal to eat it. Even the most haram thing in a normal stage becomes halal. That's why we derive from this the ruling and the principle الضروريات تبيح المحظورات. Necessities or being in a state of necessity will make halal for you the prohibited. الضروريات تبيح المحظورات. ما فقده يؤذن بالهلاك ما بعده للخلق من ملاك. After the ضروري, the society or the people, they will not have control of themselves and they don't have control of it. طيب أما الضرورات التي قد حفظت. There's the ضرورات, the necessities that been, you know, safeguard in the society to keep the society out of this state of ruin, devastation, extreme harm. He said five or six. Why he said or? Because some scholars, they say six. بِحَسْرٍ ذُكِرَتْ. I mean, they've been presented in a, you know, counted or like defined way, defined. Because the maqasid and the necessity can be extended, depends on the society. It depends on the context, depends on the time. Early in the, maybe in the mid of the last century, in majority of the countries, the cars, it was from camelliet, accessories, right? Today, cars is from al-hajiyat, they need it. It's not up to necessity, but needed. Extremely in need. People who do not have car cannot even afford to go to work. And in some of the application, they ask, do you have car? Because you don't have car, they don't even examine your application, right? Type in some society, whoever who has a car in neighborhood is like to be regarded like a rich person. So in that society, the car is not in need. Well, so, but here, when it comes to the necessity, what are the extremely needed, what, that's why we call it necessity, in the society, without it, as we mentioned, is going to lead to ruin. فَقَالَ there are five or six that we already, as you said, studied in our book of Al-Maqasid. الدِّينُ وَالنَّفْسُ وَحِفْظُ النَّسَبِ وَالْعَقْلُ وَالْمَالُ وَعِرْضٌ قَدْ أَبَى الدِّينُ faith, النَّفْسُ life, حِفْظُ النَّسَبِ protection of the nasab, families, which is the progeny, الْعَقْلُ intellect and brain, or brain, المالُ wealth and money, عِرْضٌ is the honor. The honor of a person is like his integrity, his dignity. قَدْ أَبَى, some of them, they excluded. That means أَبَى, like decline or refused. So the five, the sixth one, الْعِرْضُ, which some of the scholars, they say, is already included in حِفْظُ النَّسَبْ, in preserving and safeguarding the nasab. وحفظها جاءت به الشرائع وجتمعت لصونها الدوافع. The protection and the safeguarding of the ضروريات that we mentioned is being stipulated in the Sharia. And in the same time, you find that these element or this daruriyat, the Sharia took care to preserve them by ahkam. So it will be irrelevant if I tell you, oh, the one of the necessity in the society is to protect life. It's very obvious. The next question is said, what have you done to protect it? Right? So the Sharia tell you what is the daruriyat, and the way that set or the system to protect it. So you have the daruriyat as a fact, and you have the way to protect it as a system. قال وحصرها جاء عن استقراء لحكم الشريعة الغراء. Now حصرها to be defined to this five or six. It wasn't something done by, just thoughts for some scholar to put them down. We said it's been done by istiqra, so a careful study of all the texts of the Sharia to extract the in our Sharia what you find. The Sharia is always talking and preserving and threatening when it's violated, complimenting and rewarded when it's protected. That's the way how you get the istiqra, saying, for example, someone will commit, push someone or does things, is not as killing. So when you see the killing, you find it's a major sin, how it's been described in the Quran, how the whoever who kills, he need to be like a soul for soul. So you see from the punishment itself, how the Sharia is treating this very sensitive matter, which make us to deduct that the nafs is one of the daruriyat, and then the intent of the Sharia is to preserve it and to safeguard it. قال وحصرها جاء عن استقراء لحكم الشريعة الغراء. So استقراء of what? The analysis and the study of the text of the Sharia, the wise hikam, and to see them in the gems and the wisdom in the Sharia. وذكرها قد جاء في الكتاب وسنة الهادي بلا ارتياب. The mention of it, it was very obvious and presented in the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the guide, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, with no doubt. ففي الوصايا العشر في الأنعام, where they are related in the Quran, in Surah Al-An'am, in Surah Al-An'am, in الوصايا العشر, الوصايا العشر. الآية trying to find the آية of Surah Al-An'am. The ayah of Surah Al-An'am, starting from ayah 151. قُلْ تَعَالَوْا أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ مِنْ إِمْلَاقٍ إلى آخره. Do not associate any partner to Allah, to obey the parents, and to not kill your children, and the الفواحش, and then the yatim and the shahada, all of that. So those are, subhanAllah, constitute the main element that need to be preserved in the society. Then he said, وَحَصْرُهَا جَاءَ عَنْ إِسْتِقْرَاءٍ لِحِكَمِ الشَّرِيعَةِ الْغَرَّاءِ وَذِكْرُهَا قَدْ جَاءَ فِي الْكِتَابِ. We said, Surah Al-An'am, وسنة الهادي بالارتياب. ففي الوصايا في الأنعام أبانها من جاء بالأنعام. وهكذا في سورة الإسراء. في سورة الإسراء, as Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, starting وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا. And then Allah سبحانه وتعالى قال ولا تقتلوا أولادكم خشية إملاق. ولا تقربوا الزنا. قال ولا بعد ولا تقذوا. ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق. And then the ayah after it قال, and the وصية after, ولا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن حتى يبلغ أشده. وأوفوا بالعهد إن العهد كان مسؤولا. وأوفوا الكيل إذا كلتم. وزنوا بالقسطاس المستقيم ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا. All of that in Surah Al-An'am that you can detect from it the ضروريات. And Surah Al-Isra. And Surah Al-Isra, let's see. And just to give you the first ayah from Surah Al-Isra, if yes, starting from ayah 23, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُ إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ, and goes to, I think, ayah 32 or more. Then قال وهكذا في سورة الإسراء من بعدها في بيعة النساء. And after it in بيعة النساء, the بيعة of النساء. What is the بيعة of النساء? Do you know the بيعة of النساء? In سورة الممتحنة. سورة الممتحنة. يا أيها النبي إذا جاءك المؤمنات يبايعنك على ألا يشركن بالله شيئا ولا يسرقن ولا يزنين ولا يقتلن أولادهن ولا يأتين ببهتان يفترين بين أيديهن وأرجلهن ولا يعصينك في معروف فبايعهن واستغفر لهن الله إن الله غفور رحيم. لا يشركن إذ حفظ الدين، لا يقتلن إذ حفظ النفس، لا يسرقن إذ حفظ المال، ولا يقتلن أولادهن. They should not kill their children. This is حفظ النسب. Because why they want to kill their children? Because they did والعياذ بالله caused by zina and things. والبهتان and everything and ولا يعصينك في معروف. That's all to protect, subhanAllah, the way of following. That you need to protect the brain and the intellect. And amazingly, who can remember first why is this bay'at al-nisa, this is the oath for the women or for the whole Muslims? When this bay'ah happened? It happened before the revelation in Surah Al-Mumtahin. لو قال وهكذا في سنة المختار عبادة يرويه في الأخبار. عبادة بن الصامت, he mentioned the same item of the bay'ah in a hadith, but this hadith when it happened, it happened in al-bay'at al-aqaba al-ula, right? This is the first bay'ah that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم took from the Ansar when he met them in the Hajj in Mecca. The second bay'ah, it was different. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he presented, he said, هل تبايعوني, will you give your covenant to protect me with everything you have and protect my message and support it? And you put the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم before yourself, your family, and your children, etc., and your wealth. Now, if we studied, I don't know if you have studied together the seerah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, but this is subhanAllah, it has a very depth in it. The first bay'ah that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did with the Ansar, it was a bay'ah to prepare the society to accept the message. Because if you don't have society ready to bear the difficulties, the trials, then they will not be handling the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first bay'ah was targeting the cleansing of the individual and the society. The second bay'ah was bay'ah on jihad. So you see, subhanAllah, even in the teaching, is in the teaching of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, that you prepare the land for the rain to give his benefit. The rain is the Sharia. The bay'ah ula, they called bay'ah al-nisa, simply not because called al-nisa because it's only for the women, called al-nisa because when it was revealed in the Quran, that was the Prophet ﷺ being commanded to do, to have this element of bay'ah from the believing woman. So summiyat bay'at al-nisa, because in the Quran was addressing, to the women specifically, because the women, they don't have the burden to give the support at that time to the Prophet ﷺ by going and fight. وهكذا في سنة المختار عبادة يرويه في الأخبار. فيو سي هير سبحان الله الضروريات comes because if you don't secure this ضروريات in a society, how can you invite them to honesty and integrity and justice and fairness? You cannot. People are starving, can you tell them be quiet? Or people revolting for food, can you tell them go eat cookies? Like the Queen of France. طيب قال وواجب على جميع الناس حفظ الضرورات من المساس. And it is an obligation on every people, on everyone, to safeguard the ضروريات from to be hurt or touched or distorted. فحفظها يكون بالإيجاد ودرء ما يمكن من فساد. حفظها, how can we protect and safeguard these ضرورات? By them existing first in the society and protecting them. For example, what it means ijad, which is a nice way of presenting it. How can we have it to exist? Which is mean it is an obligation to have it first presented to this, offer it to the society. We ask people, say, people, we're going to protect your faith. They're going to tell you which faith. So you have to convey the faith. Teach the faith, then protect it. You have, subhanAllah, you have already life that is being, you know, regarded with high esteem. Then you protect it. But people, they don't care about the life of the people and they live like in a jungle. That already, you don't have the respect of life to teach how to protect it. You don't have the respect of the family, so how can you teach to protect it? Teach the respect. Teach the respect of the parents, and then make ahkam to protect that respect. But you want to punish someone who is not respecting his parents when he doesn't know that the respect is an obligation. A man came to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anh complaining his child is beating him. His child is harsh to his father. So he called him, Umar. And this is the justice. He told him, why are you doing such a thing? He said, you know, that's how we've been together. So what do you mean? He said, he didn't teach me anything since I was young. My mother was a servant. After she delivered me, he sold her. And he called me Ja'la, a very ugly name. Look at Umar radiallahu ta'ala said, قَالَ لَا تَعُقُوا أَبْنَاءَكُمْ فَيَعُقُوكُمْ. Do not hurt your kids. Uqu is like you disrespect them, you disgrace them. So they will not disgrace you and disobey you when they are old. That's why in the hadith, in the Quran, قَالَ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا. Continue, how do you continue there? رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا. As they protected me and helped me, and they educate me when I was young, came as. So it's like there's kind of a transaction. There's, you know, رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. So the one who I mean, just here mafhum mukhalafa doesn't work properly, but this is one of the story for us to reflect. So that's the ijad. So when you're talking about daruriyat, is first to have them exist in the society, to have the awareness, to teach them, teach like, you know, the importance of the intellect, importance of knowledge, to, you know, combat ignorance, you know, ummiya, people illiterate, we help them. And then you protect it from, you know, from a lot of things that would hurt the knowledge to be used in hurting people. وَدَرْءِ مَا يُمْكِنُ مِنْ فَسَادٍ. And then that is to push away anything that it might hurt this darurat. The first one, حِفْظُ الدِّين. حِفْظُ الدِّين. The first one is the protection of the faith. If you have any question, قال يقول المصنف فالدين محفوظ بحفظ الله ثم بأسباب بها نباهي تعلم لشرعنا تعليم وعمل من بعده تحكيم. طيب الدين محفوظ. الدين is protected, safeguarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. We have sent down Quran, reminder, the revelation, and is upon us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to protect it, to safeguard it. Thumma bi asbabin biha nubahi. Then there's conditions that are required from the ummah to do, to protect it. Biha nubahi is like we are proud of it. You know, and then this is the mission of everyone to do it. تعلم لشرعنا. The first one is to learn. Learn the Sharia. Knowledge, as you're doing, mashallah. تعليم. You learn it and you teach it. وعمل. And you act upon what you have learned. وعمل من بعده تحكيم. تحكيم also to have the judge into yourself and between you and others and the society is all to have the Sharia to judge or deal between you or to settle between your relationship. And the Sharia will organize it. So that's the deen. Learn it, teach it, act upon it, and make it to be your, you know, the one that is organizing and settling and ruling the affairs between peoples. ونشره, spread it. ودعوة إليه, invite to it. ثم جهاد من بغى عليه, then to strive and to protect it. Whoever who want to transgress it. فبالجهاد يستمر النفع. Is with the struggle, with the striving, that the benefit and the subhanallah, the positive impact of this deen will continue with the jihad. When the jihad stop, there will not be continuation of the benefit of this deen. What does it mean? The vehicle of this deen, you know, to continue is the jihad. Because if there's no jihad, there's no heart who care about this deen. If there's no hearts, I mean hearts by pure hearts, pure people, true believer, to care about the deen, then everything will collapse. Who's gonna be following the deen? If there is no people who are concerned about the deen, they don't care about it. If some people, they come and insult the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and the whole Ummah does not care. You think that Islam is going to exist? It's going to die. But when people, they come out and they want to protect their Prophet, I mean, in some ways are wrong, but there's still life in the heart of the Muslim about their deen. It goes up and down. But that's, so the jihad here comes with all its aspects, with all its terms, starting from striving, struggling, to the point when someone is transgressed, when someone they want to take away from his deen, he's going to fight for it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about, know those who want to drive you out of your homes and those to fight you on your own faith, those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you will help you to stand against them. Fal jihad is subhanallah, he's going to talk about it more, or actually in the tuhfa he's going to talk about Ra'sul Amri. Actually, it was the speech of the khutbah. Ra'sul Amri al-Islam. The head of the matter is Islam. The backbone of it is the Salah. Darwatu sanamihi al-Jihad. The peak is the Jihad. This is hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So what will be the leading and guiding and protecting the strength of the faith is the Jihad. The Jihad in two words is to stand for justice. Because the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, Sayyid al-Shuhada, the master of the martyrs, Hamza. To a true jihad. Qala wa rajulun qama li imamin jairin fanahahu فنهاه قالوا فقتله. In the meaning of the hadith, or كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, said the best or Sayyid, the master of the martyrs, is Hamza. And a man who stood for a tyrant, transgressor, and he talked to him openly to stop him from his injustice, and that tyrant killed him. So you see, the jihad is standing for the truth, for justice. And whatever is going to cost, if it costs life, then someone he's going to be honored by the shahada. اقرأ إذا شئت ولولا دفع الله. Now he give you an evidence. اقرأ إذا شئت ولولا دفع الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلَوْلَ دَفْعُ اللَّهِ النَّاسَ بَعْضَهُمْ بِبَعْضِ لَفَسَدَتِ الْأَرْضِ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not pushing people in a way that always that this conflict, actually this conflict, this battle that happened is to protect the earth, the whole earth will have been gone. And in the ayah, oh, in the other ayah, قَالَ وَلَا دَفْعُ اللَّهِ النَّسَبَ لَهُدِّمَتْ صَوَامِعُ وَبِيَعٌ وَصَلَوَاتٌ وَمَسَاجِدٌ. If it wasn't Allah's favor on people to push them to stand for justice, then you will have towers, temples, place of bi'ah. The bi'ah was like the place of worship of the Jews. ومساجد and mosques, all of them will be destroyed. Surah Al-Hajj. So the jihad is to protect, you know, and the justice, and mainly to protect and preserve the truth. قال وردنا لكل قول باطل عن ديننا وردعنا للقائل وحذر الناس من ابتداع من جاوز الحد ولا تراعي. واضح هون؟ So he said the other aspect after the jihad that we reject any falsehood, any saying that is wrong, that is being said on our deen. And also to reprimand the sayer of such, you know, such wrong thing or inventor of falsehood. And also from the protection of the deen is to warn people from the innovation. And from those who go beyond the boundary or transgress the boundary of the Sharia. And they do not respect it. So this is in the verse, وَحَذِّرِ النَّاسَ مِنْ إِبْتِدَاعٍ مَنْ جَاوَزَ الْحَدَّ وَلَا تُرَاعِي. حَذِّر, warn people from bid'ah, those who transgress the boundary of the Sharia. He gave us an example of the Imam of the Sunnah, how he put all his, subhanAllah, his striving and jihad to protect the deen. Here, al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. فَأَحْمَدٌ قَدْ رَدَّ قَوْلَ الْجَهْمِ وَالدَّرَمِيُّ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ ذُو الْفَهْمِ. Ahmadun, al-Imam Ahmad, he rejected the saying of the Jahm, and the Jahm, this is a group following al-Jahmi, and those they have, you know, wrong interpretation, wicked interpretation of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, studied in Aqidah. Also, al-Imam al-Darami, after him, also he continued to protect the deen and to answer, you know, all the allegation or the wrong interpretation about the deen. وَرُدَّ قَوْلَ الْكَافِرِ الزَّنْدِيقِ وَكْبِتْ دَوِ التَّلْبِيسِ وَالنَّعِيقِ. Also reject the disbeliever saying about the Sharia. And also stop those who, people of Talbis wa Na'iq. Talbisu is those who work hard to throw doubts. Yulabbis, confusing. والنعيق, those who have voices to just, you know, bother and make a lot of noise, but they don't have any impact, subhanAllah. And here, this example is everywhere. Yeah?
أمتنا في دفعها عن دينها مثل دفاع الأسد عن عرينها.
Our ummah in protecting and defending their deen, like the lions who protect their place or their zone or their sector, theirs, you know.
وقتل من بدل دين الله من حفظه فلا تكن بساهي.
And then do not forget that the one who changes his deen, the hukum of the Sharia is to the penalty of death. That's also one of the way of protecting the faith. And we explain that the apostasy and its ruling and the meaning of it and the wisdom in it.
فأحكمت منافذ الفساد وأغلقت دوائر الإلحاد.
With this aspect that we mentioned, it will be well constructed with full hikmah and wisdom and accuracy and precision in how to block any area or gaps for the deen to be hurt or corrupted. وَأُغْلِقَتْ, and being locked, all the groupment, if we can say, of Ilhad. Ilhad is a way of deviate or lead astray, and from the Ilhad is atheism. حفظ النفس. The next one, حفظ النفس. The safeguard and protection of soul or life. والنفس قد صينت عن الإزهاق. And نفس life was preserved and safeguarded from being إزهاق, to be killed. معصومة في الشرع باتفاق. Fully protected, and we say ma'suma, it's like becomes like sacred. The nafs life is sacred in Islam. So whoever touch it is one of the biggest or noxious action and ill action. ma'suma fi shar'i bittifaq, and this is an unanimous. There's no one who tell you no, it's not. This is unanimous, like a full consensus. In all the texts of the Sharia. To protect it, you know, it made obligatory al-qasas. Al-qasasu, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى, كتب عليكم القصاص في القتل. Qasas is being decreed on you in the case of killing. And al-qasas is al-nafsu bil-nafs. Soul by soul, eye for eye, etc. وحل ما من فعله مناص. وحل ما من فعله مناص. And that is the solution for such ill action. There's no way around it. كفارة ودية قد وجبت في خطأ وشبه عمد لزمت. كفارة, expiation, دية, ransom, to pay دية. It's like at the time was the value of 100 camels. This is not to kill, you know, with the premeditation intentionally. This is في خطأ, if the killing was done by mistake. أو شبه عمد, or resemble to be like intentionally. Like, for example, driving at high speed and hitting someone, person, this person should die. He could not say, the accident was by mistake. Said, you didn't have the intention to kill it, but it's like because of your speed you have killed him. So this is not intentionally, but close, shibh, resemble. So this is fihi di. Al-khata is like they playing together. He pushed him back, or someone pushed him and he pushed the other person. The other person fell from the up the roof. He died. That person is khata by mistake. But even though he has to pay the diya, it depends also on the case. قال وأخر الحد عن الزواني. And delay also think the had is the punishment for those who commit adultery. Zawani, those who commit adultery. That's actually the punishment of those who commit adultery has one of his wisdom is to protect the life of the children. Because one of the action done when a birth happened from haram, the first one, subhanAllah, to be get rid of is the child. One of the protection of the life of those babies is to aggravate in a way the punishment of the zina. So the head of the zina is also to protect the lives of the babies. قَالَ وَحَدٌ عَنِ الزَّوَانِ حَتَّى تُصَانْ أَنفُسَ الصَّبِيَانِ. So you can preserve and protect and save the life of the babies, sibyan, children. Anything that lead to قَالَ فَكُلُّ مَا مِنْ شَأْنِهِ التَّضِيعُ لِلنَّفْسِ. Anything that lead to hurt this life. Anything is forbidden. وَلَوْ تَرْوِيعُ. تَرْوِيعُ is to scare someone. Is forbidden. We're not talking about killing, we're not talking about hurting, we're not about beating, even to scare. And this is all in the protection of life and people. فَانْظُرْ وَعِيدَ اللَّهِ لِلْجُنَاتِ ثُمَّ بَتَهَجْ بِالْحِفْظِ لِلْحَيَاةِ. Look the threatening in the book of Allah for those who commit such ill action, and then be joyful for the way our Sharia protect lives. ثم بتهج بالحفظ للحياة. Next one, العقل. العقل is the brain, the intellect. العقل عن كل فساد عقل وإن يفت حتما يعم الجهل. To conceive and understand that to conceive that every and understand and know the mischief, that's actually the عقل, that's the wisdom, that's the what we call the way of good thinking, healthy thinking. I say this is bad, that's good, this is very bad. That actually the evaluation of the aql. Someone, for example, someone he's someone who did something very bad. What people they say? He's crazy, right? That's what they say. I don't know, this person must be crazy if he done, have done such a thing. Insane. That's, you know, in the talk of the people, right? So when you say, what is aql then? To be a sane person. Al-aql idhan then is to conceive and know what is bad. العقل عن كل فساد عقل وإن يفت حتما يعم الجهل. So if you don't have this existing in the society, so it's gonna ignorance, which is gonna be like spread all over the society. طيب. الدين يعم الجهل الدين والنفس وكل الحال وكل الحال عرضا مصونا ثم حفظ المال. Now he يعم الجهل. So ignorance, if we don't have the right intellect, then ignorance is gonna be all over, and ignorance is gonna touch the ignorance toward the deen, then we're gonna, the deen is going to be ruined, which is from the necessity. Ignorance about the sanctity of life, then is gonna be hurt if we have that. وَكُلُّ الْحَالِ عِرْضًا. And also when you talk about honors, وَكُلُّ الْحَالِ عِرْضًا مَصُونًا. Al-ard is the honor, dignity to privacy, all of that is also need to be protected. Then to protect and safeguard al-mal. Al-mal is the wealth.
اقرأ أخي حتى تكون عارفا قول علي قد أصبت شارفا.
Read if you want my brother to be you know to have this knowledge, the saying of Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه.
قول صحيح قد رواه مسلم.
A sound and authentic saying narrated by Muslim. Let's see if I have this hadith.
I'm trying to find this saying if I have it.
Okay. The hadith
The hadith is long, just to the story, I was reading it, about, you know, an incident where they were like drinking of alcohol, and this drinking of alcohol caused some in the hadith to lose control and to hurt Jariya, a servant. And it was not right. And this is before the khamr was haram. This is before the khamr is haram. That's why to protect the intellect, to protect the brain, the any intoxicant in Islam is haram. Any intoxicant in Islam is haram, and its wisdom is to protect the intellect. So this is the hadith of Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. بإجمال
وانظر إلى ما قد روى عثمان عند النساء يظهر البرهان
and the same he's mentioning to hadith he didn't tell us which hadith he's talking about but see if there's also hadith of عثمان يعني وضع عنوان ذكر الأثام متعددة the hadith of Uthman talking about to be away from alcohol, from خمر اجتنبوا الخمر نعم the hadith is about a story of a man in previous generation he was with a woman. She wanted him to delude him to do haram.
and mainly to kill. She said, no. She want to offer herself. He said, no. She told them, okay, if you don't do anything, at least drink from what I'm going to offer you. So he drank from what she offered him. It was wine. So when he got drunk, he accepted her body and he killed the person that she wanted him to kill. And the Prophet ﷺ called it Ummul Khaba'ith, the mother of the ill action. The mother of evil is Khabar. He refused to kill. He refused to do zina wal'iyadu billah. But after he got drunk, he did everything she asked him, that he was opposing and refusing. This is the hadith of Uthman. So look, subhanAllah, how Islam protects the intellect and consider from al-darurat, because when this is gone, there's no haya, and there's no piety, and there's no islah. حفظ العقل وانظر إلى ما قد روى عثمان عند النساء يظهر أو يظهر البرهان وفقده بالخمر في الحالين مفتاح كل الشر دون مين. According to the hadith, then when you lose someone's conscience في الحالين مفتاح لكل, it becomes the key to all evils without exception. وحفظه في الشرع بالتحريم والحد للشارب والتأثيم. And then how to protect it? The شرع is haram, the intoxicant, and then punishment for those who use the intoxicant, and they are considered and known to be sinful. والتأثيم. Any question so far? طيب حفظ النفس النسل, the next one, حفظ النسل. So we already did الضروريات, we did الدين, we did النفس life, we did العقل brain, intellect, consciousness, to preserve it. حفظ النسل, حفظ النسل, progeny, his families. So every newborn will have, subhanAllah, one of the identity and the right for every child is to have his complete identity, to know his own parents. And thus, he's protected. If not, he's going to have mix and confusion into the generation till leading to a chaos of the society. There will not be respect, there will not be that cell, you know, of the society with this nuclear family. If you explode it and you kill it, it's like you're killing the whole society. قال نسل وبضع يا أخي ونسب في أيها المقصود خلف مستحب إن يعدم النسل فلا بقاء للنوع من بعد ولا نماء. نسل, النسل, progeny. البضع is like, you know, the relationship. كما قالنا في بضع أحدكم, you know, is like known by it to be like for the wife, for the spouse, for the relation. ونسب, the نسب is the ties. في أيها المقصود خلف مستحب إن يعدمي. If this nasl is hurt, this progeny, if we don't protect it in the right way, then it's like you condemning the whole humankind to extent, for extension. فَلَا بَقَاءَ لِلنَّوْعِ. So the humankind, the race of mankind will be gone. من بعد ولا نماء, and it will not develop or grow or increase. So protecting the progeny is actually the farthest objective and intent that the Sharia, you know, want us to preserve is the race itself. Like the progeny, for example, one of the protection is the issue of abortion. That protection of the progeny. People, they want to regulate their families based on the income, economic, financial situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا تَقْتُوَ الْأَوْلَادَكُمْ خَشْيَةَ أَمْلَاقٍ. Don't kill your kids by fear of poverty or because of poverty. It's not who you providing them, it's Allah providing for them. That is part of the faith. But people, when they don't believe in the unseen, don't believe in Allah, therefore they base the whole household based on an economical or like financial capacity. And some, you know, in generation or in society, the family is known by their income. Those families don't have this income, so they are important. Less income, they are not important. And then even the relationship in the family is governed based on the income. Certain age, get out of the house. You don't have income. Go make your income. So where's the relationship of that, the ties? So it becomes ties are governed based on the financial condition. And that's hurt the nasl, the progeny. Wada. So from حفظ النفس النسل is, for example, to the prohibition of abortion is from حفظ النفس. The prohibition of zina is from حفظ النسل. It's it. وحفظ بضع لازم للنسب. And the protection of the relationship and to be, established on authentic contract with the shuhud and with the ishhar, the advertisement, and people they know, so too. To have preserved the nasab, to preserve the ties and the fatherhood and the motherhood, to all of that to be preserved. And that protection lazim is required, is a necessity for the nasab. A person, knowing his father, without that he will not know his mother or father. وَالنَّسْلُ لَا يَأْتِ بِغَيْرِ النَّسَبِ. And the progeny cannot be preserved and protected without the nasab. If you don't know the ties, say, who your grandfather? I don't know. If someone doesn't know his father, can he know his grandfather? So it's going to be mixed, confusing. All of this is protected in our Sharia. فَكُلُّهَا جَمِيعُهَا مَصُونَ فِي شَرْعِهِنَا كَالدُّرَّةِ الْمَكْنُونَ. In our Sharia, as that pearl, protected pearl, that's how this aspect is protected in our Sharia. فَالنَّسْلُ بِالْحَثِّ عَلَى النِّكَاحِ. The progeny, by recommending and encouraging for the marriage. من الولود دون ما سفاح. From the one who's capable to give and, الولود, fertile. دون ما سفاح. Without the سفاح. The سفاح is the relation, the illegal relation. تعددٍ, even through the way of more than one. If is able for the one to make just between them. لا تبتغي بشرع ربي عدلا.
Just to finish the poem. والنهي جاء عن اختصاء الرجل تبتلا زيادة في العمل.
You know, there's a method before and actually exists in some Asian kind of method for certain sect, that castration for people to lose their you know, their aptitude to get married or to have relation. So that's haram in Islam. So the protection of progeny, you find it a lot of ahkam. The relation between man and woman, you know, the prohibition to have khulwa, the attire of the sisters, the lowering gaze and modesty of the man, the castration for the, subhanallah, is forbidden for man. For men and women, women should not resemble to men, and men should not resemble to women. Encouraging the nikah, all of that is, subhanallah, from this to build all the element to protect the progeny.
والنهي جاء عن اختصاء الرجل تبتلا زيادة في العمل.
Because why they do these people, why to have to devote themselves for worship? Said no, it's haram. You don't do mafsada to devote yourself for worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the possibility to worship him and the right way how to get to him, not by doing a major sin.
وذم من يقول لا عقدت على النساء ما عشت أو قعدت.
And it is, you know, kind of criticized, reprimanded, those he said, I will never get married or I will never have, you know, عقد as long as I live.
And likewise, those who want to, you know, kind of treat the desire instead of doing by the striving of the self, he will do it by, you know, for example, surgery. He said, you know, I want to devote myself, so anything that it going to, you know, tempt me, and to avoid any temptation, you know, just, you know, to get rid of anything that use it as tools, like, you know, private or things like that. That is, all of that is haram.
تقليل نسل قبحت من دعوة.
Even to make dua for someone to not have progeny or to not have children, it's also مقبحة, very reprimanded. Cannot say such a thing.
ومثله الإسقاط للجنين. He's talking about abortion. Also, likewise, the abortion is haram.
ولو كان قبل النفخ والتبيين.
So he's from among the opinion that the abortion from the first day is haram. But we know it's haram, but there's, you know, kind of cases. So it's like, let's say all of it is haram, but it's more haram after the 120 days, after life was blown into the baby in the womb. Before that is less haram, and depends on the cases, but in general is haram.
ومثل ولو كان قبل النفخ والتبيين بالجلد للبكر والاغتراب يعرف حفظ الشرع للأنساب.
When people they commit the action of zina, the punishment of the non-married is to weep, and اختراب is to be like, you know, expelled from the town for a year, to not to be away. يعرف حفظ الشرع للأنساب. Then you know how important for the Sharia is to protect the kinship, the ties, and the nasab. وهكذا الرجم لذي إحصان. The same for the punishment of الرجم والعياذ بالله for those who are married, I mean committing adultery. قال دليل صدق بين بين البرهان. So this is give you the proof and the evidence of how sincere and truthful the Sharia in protecting the nasab. So when you say it is a necessity, then look the Sharia or the set of the ahkam of the laws that Sharia put to protect it from all what we have mentioned. Then for example, say some people, they say in our law is we protect lives. You're gonna tell him where is how, what is the system that you put in place to protect lives. We put a system to protect children. What is the system that you have put? I mean, we have, you said, we protect children. What is the system? So here the necessity said, we protect progeny, we safeguard progeny. Said, what is the system? He's gonna tell you from every individual how he observe it, relationship, violation, anything, subhanAllah, how it's set to punish the one who violated and to encourage the one who you know to be part of this endeavor and is of this nature, or we can say it nature in the humankind. وعدة ثم ثبوت النسب زيادة في الحفظ يا ذا الطلب. العدة, if there is a separation, so we have that waiting period as its wisdom is to protect the nasab, the relationship. The relationship between, you know, children and their parents. So you have a waiting period because someone, when they get separated, the woman can right away, you know, for example, can get remarried. The Sharia say, no, wait. Wait for the waiting period to be like the whole rahim womb is fully purified, cleansed. So once she gets remarried, it will be sure that the child is from the new marriage, not from the previous marriage. وعدة ثم ثبوت النسب زيادة في الحفظ يا طلب. So this is you know, is like the Sharia is overdue the protection for, subhanallah, for the over protect the nasr, the nasr. For example, say if we to protect the nasab, one cycle of menstruation is enough. The Sharia now say three. So if you put three, then you see that how important is. Say, why she has a waiting period? Said one of its wisdom is to clear anything that in the womb, if it has anything. Say, but one cycle is enough. But when to put three cycle, to have you, you know, raise into your thinking something very important. How important is the nasab? Because the more overdo things, someone is saying, count the money. He counted one time. One time is enough. He wants to be like that, counting for him is very important because it's going to be distributed for fuqara. For example, said, no, can you please count it two times more to be sure? So second time verified, third time well confirmed. That's it. It's the same amount. So the more you redo the action, which is actually a synonym or a witness of how important is the action that you're doing or related to it. The same here. That's why قال وعدة ثم ثبوت النسب زيادة في الحفظ is more, you know, an extra action for to be sure and certain of the protection. ونظرة وخلوة أو وخلوة محرمة. A gaze and seclusion between man and woman is haram. لأن تيني للزنا مقدمة. Because both gaze and khalwa are an introduction to the zina, as you know, those preparation, the path to the zina. So all you see the ahkam, how they fall together in protecting one of the great necessity in the society, which is hifdhu al-nasli. Hifdhu al-nasli. Al-irud. Al-irud, the sixth one, with khilaf. Al-irud, to protect privacy, to protect honor, to be protected from cunning against, from being you know, accused, false accused, defamation, all that is the irb. Because if someone been accused of zina and he didn't do it, that actually it hurt the nasab and the an-nasl. So here this aspect of irb is part of the hifdh al-nasr, but some scholar they put it on the side. That's what he's saying. العرض لم يذكره جل العلماء. العرض was not mentioned by the majority of the scholars. Or yeah, majority. لكونه إلى الأخير قد نما. Because he's more related to the last one we mentioned, حفظ النصر. ممن أتى بذكره القرافي. Among the scholar who mentioned is الإمام القرافي. وقد أشار فيه للخلاف. And he also, الإمام القرافي, mentioned that there's difference of opinion concerning this sixth element in from الضرورات. وعده الطوفي والسبكي وشارح الجمع والأنصاري. All are names of scholars. الطوفي والسبكي وشارح الجمع. الجمع جمع الجوامع للشارح to the book of السبكي. والأنصاري. والأنصاري وصاحب الكوكب والشوكاني والعلوي الناظم المعاني. All of these scholars that he mentioned are, you know, considering al-ird is one of the daruriyat. One of the daruriyat. Let's see if we have any. More information about these scholars for ziyadat, for more benefits, inshallah. Okay. All what he mentioned are scholars who say that the irdh is one of the necessity. والحق أن العرض ذو شقين. But in reality, العرض has two subcategories. شق ضروري بغير مين. One subcategory which is a necessity, without doubt.
كالقذف بالأنساب بالعظائم.
So what is ضروري, it becomes ضروري, is to accuse people with adultery, to accuse people that they, this is, you know, they are not this, their parents, for example. This is very dangerous. So here, this part of the earth, of preserving the earth from this perspective, it is a necessity. وَدُونَهُ, and less than that, is for people to be insulted. So that's not from the ضروري. If someone being insulted is not going to lead the whole society to chaos. But the other one, when he's been accused by illegal relationship, is going to cause mischief on the whole family, and I mean, and the hurt of the whole family.
ودونه كمثل قول الشاتم. So less than that, on a lower category, the sayer of the one who insult, say فلان ذو ظلم, this person is unjust, this person is stingy.
للزركشي جاء التفصيل. For Imam Zarkashi, in one of his book, he gave all the details of that.
والعرض محفوظ بحد القاذف. والعرض, the honor, is actually protected by the punish of the one who slander.
As in the hadith in Surah An-Nur, those who slander, قال المؤمنات المحصنات فاجلدوهن 80 جلدة ولا تقبلوا لهم شهادة أبدا.
زجرا لكل ظالم مجازف. This is to reprimand every transgressor in this case.
حفظ المال. حفظ المال.
المال من ضرورة الحياة به قيام النفس في الآيات.
المال from the necessity, wealth, money is from the necessity and needed in this life.
به قيام النفس في الآيات.
With which, you know, life, you know, is sustained by the will of Allah. As Allah subhanallah said in the ayat in the beginning of Surah An-Nisa.
وَلَا تُؤْتُوا السُّفَهَاءَ أَمْوَالَكُمُ الَّتِي جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ قِيَامًا.
Like, qiyaman is the way to establish life. With money, with wealth. So to protect the wealth is a necessity. Someone works, you know, half of his life, and someone comes and he steals everything. That's the purest of transgression.
That's why in Islam, treated in a way of very deep,
said, Allah honored you with life, Allah honored you with limbs. If you stretch your hand to take what is not right, you don't deserve that hand anymore because it was for you a gift to do good. You stretch your hand stays there. It's been taken away from you. And someone was disputing. He said, you know, this is an action that is not right, and this is in the society now. People change, how can we do such things and cut off hands? I mean, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He's your creator. The same person thief, skilled one in his job, get to his house and, you know, a while ago, took everything he has. So he started to dispute, to say the Sharia is not just. So in the beginning, the Sharia is not just because they do such a thing. After he got stolen, still the Sharia is not just. They told him why. He said, because carrying the hand is too little. Should someone on his heel, you cut off his head. So now because it hurts you, it becomes like the thief, he needs to do such a thing. That the Sharia is balanced. Just. Why? Because it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The wisdom of it, you know, Allah give you your life, give you your limbs, give you all the gifts that you have. If you stretch it for the haram, Allah will take it. You don't deserve it. Because you don't need, you're not in need of what you stretch your hand for. Because if you're in need, you preserve your hand and then you will be provided. That's the Sharia. A poor who will steal, they don't punish him. They give him first the means to satisfy and to fulfill this gap that he has. And then afterward, if he steals, then he's going to be punished. المال من ضرورة الحياة به قيام النفس في الآيات فنعم مال صالح للصالح محقق لأعظم المصالح. The best of the wealth is in the hand of the righteous man who fulfill with it and spend it in a great project that help, you know, the surrounding and help people and do good with the wealth. وصونه في شرعنا محقق. Protected and safeguarded in our Sharia is well established and determined. كسب وإنفاق له تعلق. I mean, people that go work and to gain it and to spend it also. So how to gain it from the halal? Spend it in the halal. له تعلق. So the way how to protect the wealth is how to gain your money. How to gain your money. Like, you know, the capital, if you have an investment, you invested in a halal, you sell the product with the profit, and everything in the halal, you sell, you know, without cheating, without things, all of that is protection of the world. The infaq, because if you're going to spend it in some people in intoxicant, you're ruining the money, you're ruining the distribution, because you are, you know, these people are contributing in development sector into the economy, who are going to ruin, the intellect is going to ruin a lot of things and have the part of the income out of the circulation of investment. So subhanAllah. So how to protect the money? You protect it first, how to make money and how you spend money. That's one of the first. له تعلق وحتم تعريف لمال ساقط حولا فيعطى بعده للاقط. And from the protection of the money and wealth, if you find something in the street that does not belong to you and it has a value, you keep it for a whole year trying to find the one who belong to it. And that's how the Sharia, the trust, we don't teach it in the Sharia for those who give you trust. Even you lose it in the street, you've been, inshallah, you know, the whole community will safeguard it for you by the law of the Sharia. وَحَتْمِ تَعْرِيفٍ لِمَالٍ سَاقِتٍ. By is being determined for someone who lost something valuable. حَوْلًا. حَوْلًا a year. فَيُعْتِي بَعْضَهُ لِلَّاقِتِ. After a year, if no one will come ask for it and reclaim it, he's gonna be given to the one who found it after a whole year. and is actually from the Ahkam al-Luqta, that he has to go to advertise it in the place where he found it. And he go to the, you know, all the stores around. He said, I found such a thing. Please, anyone who asks for it, let him know that we'll be in find it, is in this place. So he go all the stores in the market. Or he mention one, so this is depends before. Someone need to do it like, not like the wolf. You know the story of the wolf? The story like for good morality too. It's a time of the break. I'll tell you the story of the prof, the wolf. So the wolf, you know, there is like a shepherd with a lot of his lambs. One of the lamb he kept like, you know, in the back, you know, eating, and the whole lamb, you know, left. And this wolf, he did the repentance. He repented to Allah. He said, I will not eat anything haram. You know. So when he has the lamb and he's starving, he starts to say, I have to announce the luqta, you know. So, or like a goat. So he say, to whom? This goat. So he said, to whom? Very loud. To whom belong? Very loud. And he said, the goat at very low voice. So he said it many times. He said, you see, nobody came. And then he ate the goat. So this is when someone to be trustworthy, he go to do the advertisement, real advertisement. This lady, something was found. And then what is this thing? It is money. It is jewelry. Give the description. All of that, so someone had to do true and his diligence to announce it, not like the wolf, who his intention to keep it, therefore the advertisement was fake. Jazakumullah khairan, and we'll meet you after Salat al-Isha, inshaAllah ta'ala. At around 7:30, inshaAllah. We'll continue with the ithaf.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد number two قلنا الحاجيات the first category is الضرورات أو الضروريات necessities the second one is الحاجيات the difference between necessities and Haji, the needed, he going to explain it. We know that the Haji, without it, there's big difficulties in the society, leads to its devastation and a very critical problem. Al-Hajiyat, qala, ya man yuridu fahma dhil hajati, fakhudh hudita sharhaha fil ati. You want the understand of the meaning of the Hajiyat, then take, may Allah guide you, its explanation in the following. ما كان مشروعا لرفع الضيق وحرج يحصل في الطريق. Anything that is in the Sharia is legislated or put in the Sharia to remove hardship, to relieve the hardship. This is al-Hajj. This is Hajj. For example, if, for example, in the way of implementing the Salah, there's a way, for example, for the sick person, you know, or maybe that's that comes to the Rukhsa, but example, we'll have, you know, some hard condition that been requested from us while performing the Salah, which is going to be difficult. Doing obligation of doing wudu if someone is sick. You know, so that's haraj. That's haraj, that's difficult, that's hardship. The Sharia comes and remove that hardship. So we need to fulfill the Sharia, we need to be have that leniency, have that rahmah. Okay, so the Haji here comes, as he's saying, قَالَ مَا كَانَ مَشْرُوعًا لِرَفْحِ الضِّيقِ
anything. We have, if you remember, in the beginning of the introduction of the fiqh that we had in the first, sessions of the ma'had, the first generation of the ma'had. قلنا المشقة تجلب التيسير. المشقة, hardship, leads to easing or make things easy. For example, the water, you cannot use the water only if it's clean, pure, right? If you, there's a pond, and the pond, you know, is mixed with the water is mixed with the dirt, will you use it for wudu? He said yes, because it's gonna be difficult for you to filter the water so you can use it for wudu. So use it as is. Al-mashaqqatu tajlibu at-taysir. So there's facts in the Sharia are needed, you know, to relieve or to remove this hardship. قال ما كان مشروعا لرفع الضيق وحرج يحصل في الطريق. So anything that is legislated to remove tightness, hardship, you know, kind of dead end sometimes in someone's situation, that happened for someone in his path, in his path to Allah, of course. قال فشرع الحجي للتوسعة. So الحجي, the legislation related to the needed element, fact, aspect in the for the individual and for the society, is for the tawsi'a. Tawsi'a, to make things easy, to make things comfortable. لو لم يكن لوقعوا في عنت. If we didn't have this type of laws to make things easy, to relieve and remove the hardship, then it's going to be anat. Anat is like hard, difficulties, really mashaqqa in fulfilling the way of the Sharia. فَدِينُ رَبِّي لَيْسَ فِيهِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ. The religion of Allah, the deen of Allah, does not have this type of hardship. بَلْ كُلُّ ذِيقٍ بَعْدَهُ يَأْتِي الْفَرَجٍ. Actually, any tight situation comes after it relief. ما جعل جاء وما يريد وربنا اليسرى لنا يريد. ما جعل جاء وما يريد وربنا اليسرى لنا يريد. ما جعل, he put it between brackets, you know, the parenthesis. ما جعل is part from the ayah. This ayah, he put it here, from Surah Al-Hajj, ayah 78. مَا جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ. Allah didn't put or, you know, legislate in the deen anything of hardship. The ayah قَالَ يُرِيدُ. In the other, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, مَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيَجْعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ حَرَجٍ. Is not Allah will or intention for Allah to make a hardship for you in the deen. وَرَبُّنَا الْيُسْرَ لَنَا يُرِيدُ. And Allah, He intend for you ease. يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah does not intend for you or want for you difficult situation. Here, the qa'idah that we mentioned. وَعِنْدَ كُلِّ الْفُقَهَا النُّبَلَى مَشَقَّةٌ تَجْلُبُ تَيْسِيرًا تَلَى. That's the tala, which is the qa'idah. أَلْمَشَقَّةُ تَجْلِبُ تَيْسِيرًا. A hard situation, hardship, leads in the Sharia to taysir. So whenever you have mashaqqa, the hukum that comes with it is taysir. The water is very cold, I cannot use it for wudu. Warm it. I cannot warm it. I don't have. If you cannot use it, you know that it's gonna harm you. So this is hardship. They make tayam. We traveling, we don't have water, but you have, this is tank full of water. So this is for us to drink. Okay, then make tayam. The Sharia does not tell you, no, use that water and then inshallah, you might fight in the way. Now, secure the water for your drink, for the trip, for your journey, and make tayammum for things. So that even that security, that safety, is not to put you in a tight situation and make you to go through hardship. So al-mashaqqatu tajlibu al-taysir. So this is part of the sharia. وَقَدْ أَتَى التَّيْسِيرُ فِي الْأَحْكَامِ جَمِيعِهَا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ الْعَلَّامِ. And the ease in all the law of the sharia, it is in the law of the sharia, coming from the most merciful subhanahu wa ta'ala, and from the mercy of the all-knowing. فَلَمْ يُكَلِّفْ خَلْقَهُ مُحَالًا بَلْ وَضَعَ الْآثَارَ وَالْأَغْلَالَ. He didn't yukallif from taklif, to charge or to have someone commissioned to do the action. None of the action that been decreed by Allah is impossible. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the salat flying? That's impossible. Or to pray standing on your head, that's difficult, that's not possible. I cannot stand, someone is sick, sit, I cannot sit, so, you know, lay down, I cannot even lay down, just move your eyes. You know. فَلَمْ يُكَلِّفْ خَلْقَهُ مُحَالًا. He didn't decree on his creation anything that is impossible. بَلْ وَضَعَ الْآثَارَ وَالْأَغْلَالَ. قَالَ يَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِصْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِ. Actually, the message of the Prophet ﷺ is to remove all the chains and all the burden that the previous people they have in their books. وَلَمْ يُكَلِّفْنَا بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يُتَقْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَمْ يَطْلِبِ الَّذِي يَشُقُّ. And from his subhanahu wa ta'ala fadl and bounty, he didn't decree or command on us things that we cannot bear. And he didn't ask us to do anything that is hard. مَشَقَّةً فِي الْعُرْفِ لَا تُعْتَادُ خَيْرًا مِنَ اللَّهِ لَنَا يَزْدَادُ. You know, even known in the tradition, in the habit, between people that is hardship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not burden you with it. And that is the increase of the blessing and the good from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تَكُنْ مَشَقَّةً. So this is in the foundation of the ahkam. But what about a hardship that, you know, related to special circumstances? Something that comes up. قَالَ وَإِن تَكُنْ مَشَقَّةً قَدْ طَرَأَتْ. A hardship that comes up. Someone is facing a hardship. قَدْ خُفِّفَتْ بِرُخْصَةٍ قَدْ شُرِعَتْ. Then it's going to be lightened. You make it lighter by a rukhsa, a permission. Traveling and fasting, he break your fast because you're traveling. So someone, you know, he has to travel, and in this specific travel, there is a hardship. Someone working hard in Ramadan, and he's, for example, from the people who's firefighters. Yeah. And he has in day of Ramadan to be around fire and working. It's a very hardship. So the Sharia tell him, okay, break your fast. You are working hard and you are saving, you know, this is for the, you know, it's an obligation to do such a thing for those people committed to do it. Then you don't have to fast. So this is tara'at, comes, you know, something that comes up, situation, even a situation that comes up, has hardship, the Sharia has already, you know, solution for it, permission. قَدْ خُفِّفَتْ بِرُخْصَةٍ قَدْ شُرِعًا وَقَدْ أَتَى التَّخْفِيفُ فِي الشَّرِيعَةِ وَسَبْعَةٌ أَقْسَامُهُ بَدِيعَةٌ. وَقَدْ أَتَى التَّخْفِيفُ فِي الشَّرِيعَةِ. The التخفيف, to making things easier, lighter, less hard, or less, you know, it's like تخفيف is like it's not hard but it make it easier for depends when it's hard for someone's situation someone is sick the sharia will adapt at his situation to help him be connected the takhfif came to the sharia it has seven he's mentioned seven types bidya well constructed ibdalun ibdalun you change worship by worship ibdal You say if you cannot fast, you pay. Ibdal. It's very hard for me to fast. Okay, so feed some masakin. You know, I swear and you want you know to expiate my oath. He said, pay. I said I don't have money. Okay, I'll change for you. Another alternative. Go fast 3 days. إبدال تنقيص reduce if you cannot pay this depends on someone's situation تنقيص تغيير change اسقاط drop تقديم you know make things advance تأخير delay it all of it with the أحكام we have them there's a lot of examples like the تقديم advance the صلاة you cannot pray the عصر on time because you're traveling pray it in time of ظهر you know someone he's traveling driving he cannot pray ظهر say pray it in time of عصر تأخير وبعدها الترخيص الترخيص is permission shorten the prayer this ترخيص that's the seventh وكل قسم للفروع جامع and this is you find it in the branches of fiqh with a lot of examples وإن أتت مشقة معتادة فلم تخفف لأجلها العبادة. If there's a مشقة, some hardship that is, you know, common between people, so you will not reduce or, you know, make, you know, lighter or easier the worship. There is a minimum of known of tiredness. If you're tired, go sleep and then you can pray. We not tell you pray 2 rak'ah instead of 4 because you're tired. That's a mashaqqa that is, everybody has it. And this is the balance. لِأَنَّهَا لَازِمَ كُلَّ عَمَلْ Because it is, you know, لازمة is kind of associated to every action. Every action it has a burden. It has a hardship. So that hardship that is known hardships, I mean that is common hardship. بل في طعام المرء هذا قد حصل لأنها لازمة كل عمل بل في طعام المرء هذا قد حصل it might be referring here in the ta'am in when someone he has situation when he's starving and actually there is a mashaqqa and he only have the haram in front of him and then there's the permission of the sharia to avoid for him this situation of starvation which might lead him to really hurt and losing his life or you know a situation that he cannot bear then is going to be permitted for him to use the haram see here if he has any other thoughts about it.
The other thoughts about it, you know, talking about what is the most common hardship that it is known about people. So that hardship that is, you know, related to our normal action, our habits. So this will not be included in here, right? As we said, you know, every action, it has hardship. So he said, even the ta'am, your food, it requires effort to gain it. I mean, working. So that's... Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala laqad khalaqna al-insana fi kabad. He's always working hard, striving. The nature of life is a striving, struggling. So that's not the one that we are talking about here. We're talking about the hajjiyat, that mashaqqa in the path of someone that is not from the common one, from the normal status of a human being in his action and in his life.
وروعي الحاجي في العادات وفي العقود في المعاملات. الحاجي, you know, the state of the haji is being taken care of in the habits, in the contracts when we do the transaction. Example, التغاضي عن يسير من غرر في البيع تحقيقا لتقليل الضرر. الغرر is type of, you know, it has kind of cheating. You know, you buying something, he just put on the scale, but you're not sure that he gave you like 3 pounds. Might be less than 3 pounds. So the difference, the Sharia, you know, for, you know, is like make it forgiven. Why? Because that accuracy might have people to get into hardship sometimes. So some accuracy, some small thing, you know, you bought, for example, sheets or a rag, it might have some slight defect that it appeared to you as a defect. So you say, oh, this is kind of cheating. He said, maybe he didn't intend it. So things like this are forgiven. So in the Sharia, in the contract and everything, those small things are like, you know, let's be neglectful to not make it hard, you know, for the transactions and for this type, especially when it comes to the to economies and business and contracts. So that's is we call it from the Hajj. So al Hajj also take care of these things to make things flexible, smooth, and not make it, you know, to not get into the hardship and the rigidity, which is might, you know, have a negative impact on the on transaction economy and things like that. For example, الغرر هنا. قال مثل وكل عقد جاء باستثناء من أصله الكلي بلا امتراء بل كل بيع داخل فيما ذكر وفيه خلف للإمام قد شهر وفيه خلف للإمام قد شهر. Let's see what he mean about that.
يقول هنا مما يدخل في دائرة الحاجة من المعاملات كل أنواع العقود التي جاءت استثناء من أصل كلي، فمن ذلك مثلا عقد السلم، فعقد السلم هو عقد على موصوف الذمة مؤجل بثمن مقبول، فالناس في حاجة إليه لأن أرباب الزروع والثمار، يعني هذه كما قال ابن قدام. Some of the contracts, they might their form kind of look like haram, like it might lead to riba, or might, you know, kind of revoke one of the principle of, you know, buying what you have, what the seller has in his hand. As we mentioned, if you remember, we applied for the internet. So this is the istithna. He's saying as-salam. As-salam is like the customer pay money for the seller to give him the merchandise after 1 month, for example. For the seller, for the example, the buyer said, you know, I don't want to pay you the money till I see the merchandise, you have it. So that's the principle to avoid any gharar, any cheating, any. But you see, this is, you know, is going to put like a chain into the type of the transaction. So the seller said, I don't have money, I cannot get you the merchandise. So the Sharia come to make it lawful in a way to have more flexibility and more kind of have a more active, you know, relationship of mu'amalat in the economy, because it's needed. For example, the deposit, if you want to order something, they ask you for a deposit. You put a deposit without any thing in your hand. But this is, you say, as you didn't get anything, you didn't get any awad in your hand for what you have paid, then this is transaction is not right. Now the Sharia, people they say, but if you're going to apply it, then it's like we're gonna have this whole economy be like handicap. So what is our the intent of the Sharia? To avoid the cheating, to avoid like someone will be like been taking his money and he didn't get anything in exchange. So as the dharar, the harm that is gonna cause the whole, you know, let's say economy in this society, because of this, you said, okay, let's then solve this problem by allowing this part of this transaction and be watchful to not fall into the haram, which we, that's in the first place why you made it forbidden. Okay? So this is, you see, what even the need of the society, especially in the field of the transaction, to make it flow as long as there will not be cheating, there was not transgression, is the Sharia will give it. He said, yes, okay, you can do this. And this is what about, you know, the uqud mithal aqd al-salam. So he came back to what the author said. Qala, وَكُلُّ عَقْدٍ جَاءَ بِاسْتِثْنَاءٍ مِنْ أَصْلِهِ الْكُلِّي بِامْتِرَاءٍ. So there's every contract that came like an exception from the general rule, is actually to serve the economy, to not have it in a burden. So this is the hajiyat. So this is, you see, as we said in the Sharia, if you say, oh, we have a need here, and you said, yes, we know about it, and, you know, so then the society has to face it. How to face it? Say, to make it easy for them. Said, yes, we acknowledge to make it easy. Then the next question, did you? What system have you put to make it easy? So here the answer is said, yes, there's some exception. There's this, there's this, there's this. So the system being put to have this hajiyat been satisfied and fulfilled. بل كل بيع داخل فيما ذكر وفيه خلف للإمام قد شهر. Actually, any type of transaction who have this type of, you know, let's say, need
to be flexible, the Sharia will come and give that permission, as long as the haram transgression, ingestion, cheating will not be caused, or making hidden riba, that will be of course excluded. This is exactly saying what we've been saying. يقول يعني كل البيوع داخل في دائرة الحاجات. He's saying all the contract of sales are included in this field of the حاجات, are needed. Without it, you will not have transaction. You cannot have people to benefit and to get what they need and to fulfill their needs. بل كل البيوع داخل في دائرة الحاجات. All this type of transaction. وليس في دائرة الضروريات, but not in the field of the ضروريات that we mentioned. وفيه خلف للإمام, who's the imam who has different opinion than this, is قال إمام الحرمين. إمام الحرمين هو الجويني, the one that we study his book of الورقات in أصول الفقه. قال it been narrated that he oppose, or he has different opinion than the majority of the scholar of the Usuliyin in this special mas'ala, that he sees that the bay', the selling, is actually from the al-daruriyat. He sees it actually put in a higher category, which is al-daruriyat. He see that aslul bay', the origin of the transaction of selling and transaction, is from al-daruriyat. Any question? طيب. التحسينات. Let's stop here, inshallah, because we have yeah, that's it. 3 pages and we finish. So we'll do next time التحسينات, المكملات, and then فصل في المقاصد الأصلية والتابعة والمتعلقة بالمصالح والمفاسد عند التعارف. That's the last, actually, yeah, the last chapter is good. It has nice, you know, rules to retain and to memorize, inshallah. Any question?